Hi, I'm Tracy Cardwell from LPCiminelli and the host of the Buffalo Public Schools renovation program, Making It Happen. The Making It Happen show is a monthly news show that brings information to the community about the individual renovation programs at each school, along with opportunities for minority and women business enterprises and opportunities for Buffalo Public School students. The Making It Happen show is produced by LPCiminelli, and LPCiminelli is the construction manager for the program. Well, happy spring, everybody, and boy, do we have a great show in store for you today. I say happy spring because this is the time where all of our projects are just really, they're growing and they're taking full steam ahead. We're just finishing up phase four. We only have a couple of schools that are left that are still under construction in phase four, and they will be completed by the fall of this year. But phase five schools, they are all in construction and moving again full steam ahead, and we are so excited. Well, right now I am standing at Hutch Tech School, and we haven't been here in a while because this is a phase two renovated school. But a little later on, I'm going to introduce you to this month's student spotlight. Her name is Ziza Calhoun, and she is one incredible young lady. She's participated in several of LPCiminelli's Construction Connection programs, and we're just so delighted to present her to you today. But first, we're going to head over to School 53. That's Community School 53, where they are a Phase 5 school, and they are under construction. Dave Vawter, who's the project manager, is going to give us a tour, so we'll see firsthand exactly what's going on right now and what we can expect to see when the school is completed. And then we're going to head over to School 81. Now, if you remember, we've been there several times with project manager Robin Moody-Loggans. So we're going to go back and we're going to see how far they've come so far. And I know, I've been by there several times, and they are doing a great job. So I'm so glad you tuned in. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Hey guys, we are standing here at School 53, and I am joined by School 53's project site team. And could you guys please introduce yourselves?
Mark Griersbeck, project superintendent.
Dave Vawter, project manager.
Anne Marie Beauchamp, project administrator.
Well, hello everyone. Thank you so much for allowing us to come and tour today's school. How's everybody doing?
Good.
It's kind of chilly out today, but that's okay, right?
Yep. Yeah.
Okay, Dave, let's talk.
All right.
You're the project manager here.
Correct.
Now, School 53, and I have to tell the community, a little later on we're going to be joined by council member Demone Smith. This is his district, and I know this school was, you know, pretty special to Demone. At one point it was talked about being closed down, and Demone really fought for it to stay open. So we are really happy that the council member did fight for this school, because it is such a huge staple in this community. And I'm just so happy that we have Dave Vawter here that's leading this team, because we know this will be a great project at the end, and you're going to do a wonderful job at it, right?
Definitely, yeah.
Let's talk about the other schools you've worked at.
Sure. On the Buffalo Public School projects here, I've done School 82, School 192, which was Performing Arts, School 43, and now School 53.
School 53. Now, this school is about $12 million, a little less than $12 million.
Yeah, just about there, yep.
Okay. Out of all the schools that you've done, Buffalo Public Schools, how does this school differ from the other ones?
This school, what's unique about it is that there's been numerous additions and alterations over the course of the years. Mm-hmm. Actually, where this school was, the original school was built in 1894, and it was demolished in 1960.
Wow.
And what we have left here is a school from 1928, 1958, in 1971.
Okay, all right, great. So tell us what we're gonna see on this tour today.
Well, one of the interesting things as part of this project was we're demolishing one section of the building that was built as a temporary addition by the school in 1960.
Okay.
And when they built this addition in the 60s, it covered up a beautiful main entrance to the school that said BPS 53 Community School on that, and we're going to be restoring that back to its full wonder. So it's really neat that we can see that now.
We'll see
that on the tour.
We always love preservation, don't we?
Indeed.
That's what this the whole program is about. It's about preserving, you know, these beautiful buildings. Beautiful buildings. All right, well, I'm excited to see, you know, what's going on here, what we can expect to see. Mm-hmm. Mark, I know you're doing a great job over here too as superintendent.
Yeah, thanks.
All right, guys, so are we ready to go?
Indeed, let's go.
Okay, we'll be right back. Okay, Dave, we are in the auditorium. First, let me say that we are joined by Council Member Demone Smith. As I said earlier, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
All right, we're gonna have a great time. We're gonna see what's going on here.
Okay.
Okay, Dave, what's going on in the auditorium?
Well, in the auditorium here, we're gonna do a major restoration here. Previously, there was a drop ceiling which concealed the beautiful plaster ceiling and the ornate ductwork. We're gonna do a full restore. We're right now, the contractors behind us. Are restoring the plaster, and it'll be a completely painted brand new ceiling. We're going to also hook up all the ductwork and restore all the seating. All right, what is behind us is a new elevator that we're putting in the building. Previously there was no elevator, and between the 1958 building and the 1928 building, the buildings were not the same level. There is 5 steps on one floor, 3 steps on another floor. So anyone that has or needs ADA access through a building, when they come in the main entrance, they're stuck from getting into the 1928 building.
Right.
And they wouldn't be able to experience the renovated auditorium. So as part of this project, we're going to be putting in an elevator, a 5-stop elevator, that will allow us to get to the second floor of both buildings, the first floor, and the basement as well.
Okay. It's going to be exciting. Yeah. Also wanted to mention, you know, Mr. Smith here is not only Masten District Council member, but he's also a member of the Joint Schools Construction Board.
Yes.
Yes, you are. You are. And we're very proud to have you on that board. And that's why it's extra special that you're here with us today.
It was nice to see the work that we do. You know,
exactly.
Between talking about it and actually seeing
that's
what's
it.
Going on in the neighborhood. So we appreciate Seminelli for doing this.
Yes, yes. I think it's important, you know, because no one really knows unless you see it, unless you hear about it. You know, we bring the cameras in and you can talk, you know, you can hear our project managers speak about the history of the building. How often do you get to hear that?
You do, and we just got acknowledged. We got some community.
That's right.
People,
our block club people here.
People
yes.
Here, and School 53 Investment Club.
That's it.
Well, so they excited to be in here because they also was fighting to get the school done.
Well, absolutely. That's why I say this is like a crown jewel. The school is a crown jewel, and we have, you know, people like Donnie and Mama Charlene. You know, thank you for your support. You know, because our children need that.
We are standing in front of the old historic entrance to the 1928 building.
Okay.
For the past 50 years, this entrance has been covered up by the temporary addition built in 1960. So where we are now, it was totally covered up. You didn't see anything. So part of this project is we demo the building. We're going to restore this area to a nice green space, add a nice playground, and fix up this nice entrance here.
Nice.
Well, I see the cornerstone right there. 1928.
Yep.
That's the seal.
Yep. You got the school city seal on it.
So okay. So this whole area is going. This whole area is going to be a playground.
About half of it will be a nice brand new playground, and
okay.
The rest will be nice green space area.
Nice. That's going to be really nice.
And then all the brick area to our left. That's going to get restored with all nice new windows looking into the gymnasium as well.
Okay.
Behind us, what you see is where we're building the new addition. This addition is going to be approximately 12,000 square feet.
Okay.
And it's taking the place of the building that we just looked at before that was demolished, the old temporary 1960 building. However, this is on the other side where the old parking lot used to be. There's going to be 7 classrooms in this addition, 2 stair towers, and everything will be state of the art.
Okay. Now you mentioned earlier that the shape of the building, no one likes to build like straight buildings anymore. Just explain that a little bit more.
Yeah, this, in simple terms, it looks like a big L, but it also acts like a V where it gets narrower as you get towards the existing building and it gets wider as you get out further towards the road.
Okay. And who's the architect on record for this school?
This job is done by Cannon Design out of Grand Island.
All right. Great. Well, we know they have great designs. You know, we've seen some of the other schools. I think they are also doing McKinley, too. So we know that they have state-of-the-art designs in anything they touch. So it'll be great to see this new addition when it's completed, when the whole school is completed, actually.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We're located at where the new courtyard's going to be for the building. This was partially open before with the old building, but with the new addition, it's going to entirely enclose this area. Where we're standing is going to be a new exterior amphitheater, and it will be an outdoor learning classroom for the school. Part of the courtyard is what's really wild about this courtyard. It has so many different floor finishes in here. Not only does it have AstroTurf, it has synthetic turf, cool, concrete pavers, brick pavers, sidewalks, and grass.
Oh, wow.
All in this area here.
Wow.
So the kids are going to have a ball in here playing at all this stuff and learning in their school environment.
That's going to be so exciting.
All right. So you have your poetry readings and everything out here too, huh?
Poetry.
Lots of poetry.
All right. Well, you know what, Dave? Thank you so much. This was a great tour.
It's been my pleasure.
You guys are doing a great job here. Demone, thank you for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
I want to thank Donnie Hill, Miss Charlene. Thank you guys for joining us today. This was a great tour. Dave, we look forward to when it's completed, which will be
February 2013.
All right. So just a little less than a year from now, right? We'll be back. We will be back. Thanks again.
Take care.
Okay.
LPCiminelli Construction Connections is pleased to announce internship and scholarship opportunities for Buffalo Public School students. Applications are now being accepted for the following programs. Summer Management Internship. Our high school summer management internship is for Buffalo Public School students in grades 10 and 11. The program is a paid summer internship that runs from July 9th through August 24th. Applicants must possess basic computer skills and have an interest in the construction field. Applications, a 250-word composition, current transcript, and a letter of recommendation must be received by May 23rd. Discover Design Scholarship Program. This scholarship program is geared to students who have an interest in the architectural field. If you are a Buffalo Public School student in grades 10 through 12, have a desire to pursue an architectural career, plan to enroll or currently enrolled in an architectural related degree program, and have a current cumulative GPA of 2.5 or higher, then this program is for you. Accepted recipients will be eligible to receive scholarship dollars. Applications and materials must be completed and received by June 1st. To apply to the Summer Business Management Internship or Discover Design Scholarship Program, applicants should visit our Facebook page, that's LPCiminelli's Making It Happen, for further information, or you can send an email to community@lpciminelli.com. The famous proverbial quote, "Big things come in small packages," was more than likely referring to students like Ziza Calhoun. Ziza may be petite, but she's a petite dynamo with big aspirations. Ziza is a senior at Hutchinson Central Technical High School studying engineering, but plans to pursue a career in architecture. Ziza was first inspired when she was in sixth grade. She worked on a project that required her to build her dream home. Little did her teacher know, but this project sparked an internal flame that only an architect could identify with.
Well, I was assigned to create my dream house using a piece of graph paper, and the other part of the assignment was to draw what the outside of the house would look like, and that really inspired me to get into architecture because I found out that that's really what I would like to do, and I greatly enjoyed what I was doing.
After her initial taste of design in sixth grade, Ziya continued to seek out her passion by studying engineering at Hutch Tech. Her teacher, Mr. Stump, recognized Ziya's flame and suggested she apply for LPCiminelli's Construction Connections Summer Management Internship. Zaya researched the program and decided this was a great opportunity to learn about architecture, engineering, construction, and the trades. Zaya was selected and enjoyed visiting various construction sites. She was most impressed with learning the full process of a construction project. She learned that before a shovel goes into the ground, there are many phases to the completion of a project. She experienced the important role of estimating, accounting, marketing, and safety departments and how they all work together to ensure each project is built successfully. To give Zaya another perspective, she was teamed with one of our BPS partners. Her 2011 summer experience as an intern proved to be invaluable. Zaya soon became a familiar face on the Construction Connection scene. After her stint with the summer management program, she enrolled in the newly created Discover Design program. Discover Design is a boot camp program that exposes students to the many different aspects of architecture. At the end of the one-week program, participants are asked to present their personal designs to a panel of judges. This experience, known as a mock crit, gives students a real insight into the college life as an architecture student. Zaya's presentation awarded her second place and a $1,000 scholarship.
Well, the best part about the Discover Design program was the mock crit that we had at the end of the program. It really prepared me for what I'd be doing in college because I'm going into the architecture major. And it also helped me develop my modeling skills for my project.
Through her determination to continue her studies of architecture, Zaya enrolled in our TEAM program. The after-school program offers high school students hands-on experience to technical, engineering, architecture, and construction-related careers from industry professionals. Zaya feels that the career she chose is a bit challenging, but participating in programs like TEAM, Discover Design, and the Summer Management Internship will help her overcome these challenges and be a successful student and architect. When asked, what advice would you give your classmates?
Always pursue your dreams, and if you've thought about it in your head, keep visualizing it and don't let that go, because if you think about it hard enough, you can achieve it. And just no matter who tries to get in your way, no matter what kind of adversity you come across, you should always just press forward and go for what you believe in.
LP Ziminelli congratulates Ziza Calhoun on being this month's student spotlight. Through hard work and determination, she's bound to be one dynamic architect.
The last time you've been here, we've done a lot of work. We've got a lot of work done, getting ready to wrap things up.
Mm-hmm.
Right now we're in the cafeteria area.
Okay.
And I don't know if you remember, this was originally tech shop, music room, library, and art room. We gutted the entire area and turned it into the kitchen cafeteria area, which was originally up on the level three.
Yeah, this used to have a wood floor at one time. I don't know if you remember or not.
Oh, yeah.
The demolition on that for a new finish.
So, big difference.
Came out yep. Nice.
Definitely big difference. Definitely brighter. We got the new skylights and everything, so it brings a lot of light into this area. We have this is the sitting area that we're in.
Okay.
And then we have the kitchen area, and behind us we have the serving line as well.
All right. Great. Well, you know, we are at School 81. It's been a while since we've been here, and we can tell, you know, by all of the new work that's being done, just this room alone. I mean, I can remember the first time we were here.
Mm-hmm.
The very first time, it was extremely dark, and they were demoing the floor. It was kind of scary, if you ask me. What a difference. It's beautiful. It's bright. The colors.
It wasn't very nice.
No, it wasn't. You know, huge difference. But I'm loving the colors of the floor.
Yeah, really bright.
Yes, and how the walls are matching the different panels on the floor. Who's the architect again?
Watts,
okay. Great job. And I mean, the skylights really, they really do brighten up this room. This is beautiful.
It makes a big difference.
Yeah, it does. So
I think your kids will like it.
I know they'll love it.
Yep.
I know they'll love it. So I'm so excited about all the other great things that we're going to see, that you guys are going to show us today. Okay?
We'll head over to the auditorium.
All right, let's go.
All right. Okay.
Definitely, we are in the auditorium, obviously. And I remember the last time we were here, there were no chairs.
Yep, we had sent them out to be refinished. They refinished them, brought them back in, installed them. The only thing left to do now, we have to get the window treatments.
Okay.
The stage and the window treatments. And some touch-up paint, and we're all set. We got the floor, the stage refinished, and we need to get some carpet. So we'll be good. And we preserved the mural.
Beautiful.
Everything is back.
Well, I was telling Lee that I'm loving the powder blue. I like the pastel colors that you can see throughout the whole school. I don't know, it's different. It's just different. You normally see...
Not as institutional.
Exactly.
Are,
you know? Yeah. It's so nice. It's softer. It really is. I love the way it teams up with the neutral color at the bottom, too. This is really nice. I mean, this is a huge difference.
And when we can get
yeah.
It turns out really nice.
Yeah, beautiful.
It's a much improvement.
Oh, yeah. And the chairs are up in the balcony, too, right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so just got carpeting and touch-up painting and the curtains, stage curtains.
The window treatments, the bed of the year.
Cool. Yeah.
We're in Home and Careers. We just recently got all of the residential appliances delivered, which are the stoves, refrigerators, dishwasher, washer and dryer. The area we're standing in now is, of course, the workspace, and then behind us across there is the instructional space. So this really turned out nice.
Mm-hmm.
This was the original space for Home and Careers, but of course it, you know, just got updates and it just looks a lot better. The equipment is, you know, more modern and up to date, so it really turned out well.
Wow, what a difference, It's obvious we're in the library. Talk to us, Lee.
Yeah, the contractors did an excellent job.
Yeah.
The woodwork on the shelves, the lighting, particularly for this room.
Mm-hmm.
It's the only place we have this type of fixture. You can see that the millwork is in place, the working desk. You can see back behind us to the right, there's a book reading niche.
Reading
note for the kids and some more shelves.
Mm-hmm.
It came out really well. I think the kids will like this.
It is absolutely beautiful.
It's nice and homey and comfortable, and particularly with all the wood that we have.
Oh yeah, it's beautiful.
It is. That makes a difference.
It does.
The science room, pretty good size, square footage wise. You can see the teaching station over to my left. This will be, I think, capacity of 40 kids or something like that?
35, 40.
And as you can see, it's nice and bright, fresh, and I think the kids will like this also.
Mm-hmm.
It's a marked improvement over most science rooms, classrooms.
All right, so we're in the shop tech room. We could tell by the electrical cords hanging from the ceilings. This is another pretty cool room. What's going on?
Well, like you mentioned, there's power cords, reels for small tools that we're using probably.
Mm-hmm.
Like whatever. And, adjacent to it, there's a workshop.
A workshop, yeah.
Okay.
Intersecting or interconnected door,
right?
So that they'll be able to travel back and forth between the two rooms, and they're not going out to go around the quarter.
Okay, really nice. And then I like the windows where you can see what's
going on
in both sides of the room. This is nice, a nice, very clean, open space.
And there's computer workbenches on both rooms.
Okay. Very nice. And then the closets back here, that's like for
storage. For the tools and equipment. Yeah.
Okay.
And material and tools.
Uh-huh.
And things like that.
Very
nice.
This is
for 7th and 8th grade.
I think it's for the upper classmen, and then also the FF&E, the furniture is coming, and it'll be work tables.
Okay. Nice. And this is the only one, right?
Yeah.
The only one. Very nice. They'll love it. And now all of this, let's just mention it again, this is in the new addition.
Yes. New addition
of the school, which is huge. I mean, the school was already big, and now with this new addition, it's even bigger.
About 25,000 square feet of new structure.
Very nice. I know students, they're just going to love it when they come back. And when will they come back?
They're coming back for September.
Of this year?
This year.
Nice.
We're now standing in the new main office, which is located in the new addition. Mm-hmm. The existing main office was in, of course, the existing building. This space is a lot brighter, a lot more storage. We have a lot of new millwork, so it's really a nice space. We have a check-in counter, cubbies for the mail, for the teachers, everything. So it's really turned out to be a really nice space. We still have a little bit more work to go, but when it's done, it's going to be really nice. We're outside and we're at the playground. We have a nice playground structure, and we also have a bridge, benches, and a runnel or rivulet, which is like a stream that goes throughout the entire site.
It's really nice. I love the playground apparatus. It's very different.
Very unique.
Yes.
You don't see too many playground equipment like that.
Now I got to ask, who picked that piece? Was it the landscape?
The landscape, like
Joy Keebler.
Yeah.
I absolutely love it. And I know kids will love it. They're going to see that. I mean, it makes me want to go jump on it, you know, and try it out.
Figure out what to do, but yeah.
Yeah, well, that's the beauty
part
of it.
Exploring
it may take
of it,
the
yes.
kids a little while to get used to it, but
right.
they'll like it. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And I'm loving all the green space that they're going to have here. Are there going to be more trees or?
No, pretty much what we have is what it is.
Pretty much in.
Okay.
Yeah, that's about it.
Very nice.
And then this
yep.
is the loop for the buses, because Tacoma is such a busy street. They
right.
have a turnaround loop for the buses.
Very
back
nice.
Here as well.
Okay. Well, this is great. I mean, the school looks absolutely beautiful. Being out here, seeing the new addition from the outside, it really puts everything in perspective.
Yeah. It's not a bad looking. Addition.
Not bad at all. You guys are doing a great job.
Thank you.
Yeah, you guys know it though. You're all pros at this. We only get the best though, right?
You were so old in there, didn't you?
Sorry. How about seasoned?
Yes, seasoned.
Good work.
Yes. All right, guys.
Okay.
Listen, always love coming here. We'll be back again.
Again?
Yes,
oh, okay.
again
all
in
right.
September.
In September for the grand opening.
For the grand opening.
Some grass.
Yes.
Yeah, it'll look good.
Yes.
All the furniture, everything.
Furniture and everything. Yeah.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay.
See you later.
We'll be back.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right. Well, that concludes our show for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'd like to thank all of my guests and say congratulations again to our student spotlight this month, Ms. Ziza Calhoun. Don't forget, we are on YouTube. Go to YouTube, type in LP Ciminelli's Making It Happen. There you'll be able to view all of our past and current shows. We are on Facebook. Please check our Facebook page periodically. LP Ciminelli's Making It Happen. There you'll be able to get any applications, like for our summer internship program, our Discover Design program. It's all coming up fairly soon, so don't forget, check our Facebook page. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, you know the number. Give us a call. Thank you so much for tuning in, and until next time, let's keep making it happen.